Most of my work is in genomics and bioinformatics. So what I'm mostly interested in is making sense of sequence data. So we can generate a lot of sequencing data from various populations, environmental populations, veterinary animals. I've been working with data from the JGI for about 15 years. My first project was really working with large-scale genomic data from sea urchin genomic regions around developmental genes of interest. And we would get 100 kb long assembled backs from the JGI sequencing pipeline, and we'd try and look for conserved non-coding regions that were putative or candidates for being regulatory elements. And at the time, like, none of the software existed for doing this, or the software that did exist didn't work properly. And so I worked in the lab with the data, with the biologists using the data. So I was a graduate student, and I'd work with other graduate students and postdocs on analyzing their data, and ended up building a system that would let you take the data that JGI produced and put it into a computational website that would let biologists analyze it themselves without ever talking to me. And it got to the point where there were 20 or 30 people using the system to do their own analyses, never talking to me beyond occasional feature requests, and just getting on with their science. And I thought that this was really a fantastic way to do science, because I could go and do the interesting stuff that I wanted to do, which was actually also some experimental biology. So that was my first project dealing with JGI data. My second project, and really sort of the defining project of my independent scientific career until now, was the Great Prairie Grand Challenge. And this was a project that was led by Jim Teagy and Janet Jansen and Susanna Tringe at JGI. And essentially, it was an effort to see what we could understand about soil by using shotgun metagenome data. And a lot of our tools and approaches for dealing with this data are not that great. I'm interested in improving the tools and methods that we use for looking at these data sets so that biologists and environmental scientists can do their work, which is usually downstream of sort of the sequence analysis and getting into what the function of various genes and organisms is, cross-referencing across different data sets and different publications and different work, and basically doing all the follow-on, all the work that is more interesting actually in many ways than the sequence analysis. When the JGI gets involved in a project, it's very deliberate, and it's very exhaustive is maybe the wrong word, but it's very deep. And this gives the data sets a different level of depth, for lack of a better word, that makes them particularly interesting to work with, because you know that these are the kinds of data sets that many people will be having in the not so distant future. So I view JGI as kind of a leader in I view JGI as leading the way, leading the pack is maybe a better word. I view JGI as leading the pack in terms of what kinds of data people are going to be generating now and in the near future.